The effort to spare Kelly Gissendaner's life went well beyond the time when she should have been dead. Prison officials put the 47-year-old convicted murderer's execution on hold to let the legal process run its course.
She was very strong, and she was very assured in whatever the process was going to be. And she handled herself with poise that was just beyond belief.
But when the last court turned her down, time and hope ran out. Gissendaner's attorneys weren't the only ones fighting on her behalf. Her grown children begged a parole board to commute her sentence to life in prison.
She's so supportive of me. I can talk to her about anything, any troubles I have or anything that I want to celebrate, and I know that she's my biggest cheerleader. My brothers and I really want my mom to live. She is all that we have left.
Even the Vatican weighed in with a letter from an emissary of the Pope. Quote, "Please be assured of my prayers as you consider this request by Pope Francis for what I believe would be a just act of clemency," it read. But others felt that her sentence for the 1997 murder of her husband was just. Doug Gissendaner's parents said in a statement, quote, "As the murderer, she's been given more rights and opportunity over the last 18 years than she ever afforded Doug, who, again, is the victim here. She had no mercy, gave him no rights, no choices, nor the opportunity to live his life." Kelly Gissendaner planned her husband's murder, but did not do it. The beating and stabbing death was committed by her boyfriend, Gregory Owen. In a separate trial, Owen actually got a lesser sentence of life with the possibility of parole. The disparity between his sentence and hers was a point attorneys and death penalty opponents focused on as evidence of a flawed judicial system. There was also Gissendaner's life after her conviction, in which she turned to her faith, studied theology, and counseled fellow prisoners. In a strange twist, two previous execution dates were postponed, once by a winter storm, another when the expert said that the chemicals that made up her lethal injection looked cloudy. With her execution, Gissendaner earns two very different distinctions: the first woman executed in Georgia in 70 years, and the last woman on Georgia's death row. Martin Savidge, CNN Center, Atlanta.